So the scams that are working less for consumers now are the untargeted scams. So untargeted scams like, you know, the traditional Nigerian princess scams and, you know, you've inherited this amount of money, and they aren't specific to the recipient. They're not working very well, and they're in steep decline as a result. One of the untargeted scams that is working, and the exception to this, is the authority scam. The authority scam plays on people's willingness to help, say, the government track a criminal or find a fraudster. And it often goes like this, that you get an email from, say, the FBI or the government in general, saying that there's somebody at your Western Union office or at your bank who has been stealing money. And we're going to figure out who it is and collect evidence. You can help us. Send $1,000 to this person and you'll get it back right afterwards. And you know, of course, people who do that don't get it back right afterwards. That's the one scam that seems to work among the untargeted scams. It's the number one scam for elderly to fall for. So in terms of gender and scam, it's interesting. For example, women in their 20s and 30s, they fall for what's called housing scams. Renting an apartment that, you know, doesn't exist, or at least it's not owned by the person who's advertising it. In their 40s and 50s, it's romance scams. So they're dating somebody who doesn't exist. And in their 60s and up, it's this government scam or authority scam. Men of almost all ages, 20s to 50s, fall for auto scams. So they buy cars that don't exist, or they sell their cars to somebody who's paying with a bouncing check and therefore gets the car and maybe the shipping money as well. And in their 60s and up, it's the government scams, with a close number two being the auto scam. Business email compromise. These scams are targeted against enterprise users who are getting an email from somebody within the organization or a supplier or somebody they know. And it's a business as usual request. So here's an invoice, or we're completing the acquisition, but we need the funds to be transferred to this account instead of the other one. And either they're spoofed, so they seem to come from the account of the apparent sender, or another domain is created that looks almost just like the intended sender, and people don't spot the differences. If the recipient of a message isn't so sure, it's a great idea to pick up the phone. That's the last thing the scammer wants, of course, except if they include a phone number to call in the email. So never call the phone number in the email, but look up the number of the person you think you're getting an email from and check. Is this really what you want me to do? I just want to check. And that's the safe thing to do, and it's a good thing to do. And that would have stopped many of these frauds.